Greetings. This is part 5 in a series for people to understand all the ways Islam tries to prove Muhammad is not a liar. This is more of a problem than you might imagine, my friend. Ignore for the moment the reality that Muhammad was a liar. Ignore for the moment that Islam is not from God, and just imagine, you are a sincere Muslim. You were told that you must first believe the Quran is the only true message from Muhammad's Allah. Once you believe that falsehood and are committed to it, you do not have much choice in your direction in life. You are not allowed to critique or question the words in the Quran. You must accept them, and you must defend them, and you must view any challenges to them as attacks against your Allah. So, how does a person in Islam defend Surah 7, 157, which claims Muhammad is found in the Torah and Gospel? First, you take it with faith, and you get excited. After all, finding Muhammad in the Bible would prove the Quran was true, and it would silence those damned infidel pagan Christians forever. They mock Allah and exceed their religion. And it is the jihad of every real Muslim to attack them and revert them to Muhammad. And all you have to do is prove the claims in the Quran are true. Clear claims that say Muhammad is described in the Torah and Bible. How hard can that be? Allah said it could be done in Muhammad's day. No need for fancy schmancy computer searches. Just look for the name Muhammad in the Torah. And you know what? After hundreds of years, perhaps even 1,000 years, maybe even 1,400 years, someone in Islam finally found something in the Bible that coincidentally appears to seem to resemble the name of Muhammad. It's the Hebrew word transliterated as Mahmad. In parts 1 through 4, I mention just how desperate Islam is to prove Muhammad is not a liar. I'm about to show you one example of their desperation. His mouth is sweetness itself. He is altogether lovely. This is my beloved. This is my friend, daughters of Jerusalem. The New Living. His mouth is sweetness itself. He is desirable in every way. Such, O women of Jerusalem, is my lover, my friend. English Standard. His mouth is most sweet, and he is altogether desirable. This is my beloved, and this is my friend, O daughters of Jerusalem. New American Standard. His mouth is full of sweetness, and he is wholly desirable. This is my beloved, and this is my friend, O daughters of Jerusalem. King James. His mouth is most sweet. Yea, he is altogether lovely. This is my beloved, and this is my friend, O daughters of Jerusalem. The Holman Christian Standard. His mouth is sweetness. He is absolutely desirable. This is my love, and this is my friend, young women of Jerusalem. New Living. His mouth is sweetness, and all of him is desirable. This is my beloved, this is my friend, young women of Jerusalem. I've been highlighting a particular phrase, as you may have noticed. Altogether lovely, desirable in every way, altogether desirable, wholly desirable, absolutely desirable, all of him is desirable. All of these phrases are translations around the Hebrew word Mahmad. Mahmad is a Hebrew word spelled with 4 letters. Mem, Chet, Mem, Dalet. Because this word can sound like Muhammad if it is mispronounced, and because Islam is desperate to prove Muhammad is not a liar, and because Islam has no legitimate references to accomplish this, they are willing to try and make the claim that Mahmad is the name of Muhammad. Somehow, they hope that this fills the mention of Muhammad in the Torah and Gospel. But let's carefully and factually look at why this cannot be the case. There is actually a rather long list of arguments against Islam's claim that this is Muhammad. 1. This is in a book that Islam reviles and mocks, rejects as pornographic. 2. Let's see how it reads when you substitute Muhammad for Mahmad. 3. If this case of Mahmad is Muhammad, then all cases of Mahmad are Muhammad. 4. Does this mention a prophet? 5. Does it mention him as unlearned, as cannot read and cannot write? 6. Is this even in the Torah or the Injeel? 7. Is this really the best evidence that Allah could create and sustain? Let's visit these one by one and kill this error, deception, lie from Islam. 1. This is in a book that Islam reviles and mocks and rejects as pornographic. Now, if you were God and you were about to reveal your last and greatest prophet, the seal of the prophets, the last word you would ever give, the final message, would you hide it in a book offensive to the very believers, Muslims, who you were trying to secretly communicate with? Though I suppose the Islamic dodge could be that it was for pagans and infidels to find Muhammad magically appearing in the text of the pornography that pagans read. Don't bother wondering how Islam can simultaneously call Song of Solomon pornography, yet find it miraculous that their prophet appears amongst the filth, smut, and erotica. Blind faith in Islam means never having to question anything. But why does Islam call it pornography? Because it speaks clearly about romantic love between a man and his wife. Songs 1-2, let him kiss me with the kisses of his mouth, for thy love is better than wine. 2-6, his left hand is under my head, and his right hand doth embrace me. 2-10, my beloved spake and said unto me, rise up, my love, my fair one, and come away. 3-1, by night on my bed I sought him whom my soul loveth. I sought him, but I found him not. 4-5, thy two breasts are like two young roes that are twins, which feed among the lilies. 5-4, my beloved put in his hand by the hole at the door, and my bowels were moved for him. Sorry if this makes you squeamish, O Mohammedan, but this is the text Islam claims Muhammad miraculously appears in. Let's move on to 2. Let's see how it reads when you substitute Muhammad for Mahmad. His mouth is sweetness itself. He is Muhammad. This is my beloved. This is my friend, daughters of Jerusalem. His mouth is sweetness itself. He is Muhammad. Such, O women of Jerusalem, is my lover, my friend. His mouth is most sweet, and he is Muhammad. This is my beloved, and this is my friend, O daughters of Jerusalem. His mouth is full of sweetness, and he is Muhammad. This is my beloved, and this is my friend, O daughters of Jerusalem. His mouth is most sweet, yea, he is Muhammad. His mouth is sweetness, he is Muhammad. His mouth is sweetness, and Muhammad. That just doesn't work. It doesn't flow. It doesn't make any sense. The claim that this is Muhammad mentioned by name, as if mentioned by name is an amazing and irrefutable miracle, just does not pass the sniff test. This was written before 1000 BC. That's 1600 years before Muhammad. It is unlikely that a woman living in Jerusalem 1600 years before Muhammad was born would claim he was her lover. Let's move on to 3. If this case of Mahmad is Muhammad, all cases of Mahmad are Muhammad. That is part of being consistent. The more the merrier. The more times that Muhammad appears, the more proof you have, O Muslim. Let's just dogpile and see how many times Muhammad appears in the Bible. 1 Kings 26, and it shall be that whatsoever is pleasant in thine eyes, they shall put it in their hand and take it away. And it shall be that whatsoever is Muhammad in thine eyes, they shall put it in their hand and take it away. Does that make any sense? 2 Chronicles 36:19, and they burnt the house of God and brake down the walls of Jerusalem and burned all of the palaces thereof with fire and destroyed all the goodly vessels thereof and destroyed all the Mohammed vessels thereof. Does that make any sense? That's Mahmud. That's Mohammed. This is Mohammed in the Bible. Isaiah 64:11. Our holy and our beautiful house, where our fathers praised thee, is burnt up with fire, and all our pleasant things are laid waste. And all our Mohammed things are laid waste. Does that make any sense? No! Lamentations 1:10. The adversary hath spread out his hand upon all her Mohammed things. Does that make any sense? Substituting the word Mahmud, the same word Mahmud, with Mohammed. Lamentations 2:4. He hath bent his bow like an enemy. He stood with his right hand as an adversary, and slew all that were pleasant to the eye in the tabernacle of the daughter of Zion. And slew all that were Mohammed to the eye in the tabernacle of the daughter of Zion. Does that make any sense? No. Substituting the name Mohammed for a Hebrew word Mahmud does not make sense. Ezekiel 24:16, Son of man, behold, I take away from thee the desire of thine eyes with a stroke. Behold, I take away from thee the Mohammed of thine eyes with a stroke. Does this make any sense? No. Ezekiel 24:21, Speak unto the house of Israel, thus saith the Lord God, Behold, I will profane my sanctuary, the excellence of your strength, the desire of your eyes, and that which your soul pitieth. I will profane my sanctuary, the excellency of your strength, the Mohammed of your eyes, and that which your soul pitieth. Does that make any sense? Doesn't this prove this is Mohammed? It's the same word, Mahmud. That's Mohammed, right? Ezekiel 24:25. Also, thou son of man, shall it not be in the day when I take from them their strength, the joy of their glory, the desire of their eyes, and that whereupon they set their minds, their sons and their daughters? When I take from them their strength, the joy of their glory, Mohammed, of their eyes, and that whereupon they set their minds. Does that make any sense to just plug Mohammed in where the word Mahmud appears? That is 8 examples of the 12 uses of the word Mahmud. It simply makes no sense to claim any occurrence of the word Mahmud is the name of a man, Mohammed. Number 4. Does this mention a prophet? His mouth is most sweet, yea, he is altogether lovely. This is my beloved, and this is my friend, O daughters of Jerusalem. Even if you think this is the name Mohammed. Ta-da! Mohammed! There is no mention of the word prophet in this verse. There is no basis to claim this verse or even the chapter foretells of a prophet. 5. Does it mention him as unlearned, as cannot read and cannot write? Remember the description that Allah said you would find. Remember the description that the prophet would neither read nor write? Is this even in the Torah or the Injeel? Actually, it is not. The Torah is the law that Moses brought. The Torah is the first 5 books, Genesis, Exodus, Leviticus, Numbers, and Deuteronomy. And while there is a misnomer that the whole Old Testament is the Torah, I am going to ask you, Muslims, to respect the sage of Islam, Muhammad. Surah 2:136. Say, we believed in God, and what was caused to descend to us, and what was caused to descend to Abraham, and Ishmael, and Isaac, and Jacob, and the tribes, and whatever was given Moses, and Jesus, and whatever was given to the prophets from their Lord. It is clear that Moses revealed the Torah, the first 5 books. So when Allah says, you will find something in the Torah, it means the first 5 books. So even if this were a reference to Muhammad, it is not in the Torah, so it cannot be the reference Allah said you could find. 7. Is this really the best evidence that Allah could create and sustain. Imagine for a moment, you are Allah. Now, as Allah, you are going to send your last, your final prophet. Never again will you be able or willing to send someone to fix things. And you need people to know this man is the big deal. With your last and final revelation on the line, is this a coincidental mention, a word in a foreign language that sounds like a person's name? Is this really the best you can do, the all-knowing, the all-wise, the most beneficent? You do not even bother to predict any relevant details of the man. You just say, he is Joe. In a context, talking about a woman's lover, not a prophet. I've shown you, O Muslim, seven arguments why Song of Solomon 5:16 cannot be a mention of Muhammad. Each argument is sufficient in its own right to disprove the claim this is a mention of Muhammad. And more importantly, it cannot be the verification of Sura 7, 157 through 158. Islam's claim about Song of Solomon 5:16 does not prove that Muhammad did not lie. I encourage you, O Muslim, to use the brain that God gave you. Respect God and respect the truth. If you place any value on the truth, you cannot accept this verse speaks of Muhammad. May the Spirit of God open your eyes to the light, your ears to the truth, and your heart to His Son, the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen.